It's me, Headaches. Today we're playing Fishy. I'm just playing with everything. So let's just return. This is what it looks like. Pretty cute. Found this on Itchio. It's free. You know. Let's start. Honestly, you didn't even want to come here. I don't like aquariums either. The ocean has never been your thing. There are sharp things you can step on. And colorful things that inject poison into you when you touch them. And large things that are faster and stronger than you. And the worst part, they're all alive. And they're hungry. Mom, I'm out of sparkling water. I turned to look at the instigator of your distress, Monica. It's her 14th birthday. Last year for her birthday, Monica's parents rented the local theme park for a whole day. Oh my god. Entire class had gone. Ugh, gross. Gone to ride the big kid rides for the first time. Everyone talked about it for the rest of the year. As the day approached again, talks started to shift. What would Monica do for her birthday this year? All this sinking feeling in your stomach when you found out. Ugh. You're invited to Monica's 14th birthday overnight, a marine adventure. Gross. Spend an evening at the aquarium exploring the exhibits before tucking into your sleeping bag for a night under the sea. I wouldn't go. Mom, this sparkling water is cherry flavored. Gross. Typical Monica. Gross. Just Monica. Your classmates swarm the lobby excitedly, stepping over sleeping bags and toothbrushes that no one has any intention of using. Aquarium employee is going student to student handing out ID badges. Stand alone. Where's Misha? Why isn't she here yet? She promised. She didn't go because aquariums are just horrible. Remember that day at lunch where she convinced you? I'm sorry, what is she wearing? What is this? You have to come. It'll be so fun. And if you don't go, you'll miss out. Everyone else is going. You'll be the only kid in our class who cares. Look, I know you don't like fish or oceans or like water or whatever. You'll probably like it once you get there. It's not like we're swimming with sharks or anything. There's no actual danger. I'll be with you the whole time. Promise. But you're a liar. Well, you're here and Misha isn't, so that's cool. Door to aquarium opens. Misha? What up, nerds? Ew. Uh-oh. Toby drops his bag near the door and runs over to Monica, holding his hands above his head like a shark. Then, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Stop it, Toby. You're so annoying. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Toby isn't in your grade, but he's Monica's older cousin, so he usually ends up at her parties anyways. Aquarium guy approaches you with a friendly smile. Oh, get out of here. Hi there. I'm going to print you an ID card. Would you help me fill out one for you? Name? Oh no. My name is Head. Thank you, Head. Favorite sea creature? What are they called? They're like stingrays. My favorite too. What is that? There you go. Don't lose it. She's looking cute. She's looking nice. Look at those waves. I don't want to know what happened. Thanks. Aquarium guy looks around. He's kind of sus. Kind of looking sus, guys. I think that's everyone. Let's go ahead and start. Wait, my friend isn't here yet. I'm sure they'll be here soon. Besides, the majesty of the aquarium waits. She's dead. He gives you two thumbs up and then heads over to Monica's parents. Your parents are here. Attention, everyone. Sparkle. Monica's standing on a bench, gesturing wildly. Your classmates quiet down and gather around her. Thanks for coming to my birthday. Tonight's going to be really fun. You have free run of the entire aquarium, so you can do whatever you want. Well, not everything. Actually, some of our exhibits are under construction or closed temporarily for one reason or another, so please stay away from any off-limits areas. Just try to keep you kids safe. Oh, okay, why are you sweating so much? God looks nervous. You wonder what that's about. Anyway, it's going to be tons of fun. But sure, restricted areas, there will be cake and presents later. You're a little anxious. Trace the revenge of your prosthetic. Oh, also, we have unlimited LaCroix? I hate that drink. It's so go wild. Gross. Thank you, Monica, and happy birthdays. Now, everyone, we're going to enter the aquarium. We'll walk through the magnificent jellies, exhibit, and drop off your stuff in the deep ocean room. You'll be sleeping next to our 1.1 million gallon saltwater tank, our largest tank. Dredge shoots through your body. You'll be sleeping where? Follow me, we're going to have a really special night. Okay. Oh, that's cool. That's really cool. Stark inside the jellyfish's exhibit. Catch a glimpse of the faces of your classmates, illuminated by the glow of the tanks. Walk along the black velvet floors, keeping to the back of the group. Don't know these people very well, but they all seem to be best friends, plus Stark. Home to the large shape in front of you. Hey, watch it, freak. Hang on. Weirdo. Random guides. You call me a weirdo even though I just... Okay. Stops in front of a wide tank with rounded edges. This is pretty cool. Jellyfish float gently behind him in a seemingly endless void. Imagine this just being a TV. It's just fake. Now, like I said, we're going to drop off your stuff at the deep ocean floor. Oh, deep ocean room. After that, you're free to explore the aquarium until bedtime. What if I don't want to stop that at that time? We have a few rules. No running, no tapping on the glass. I'm going to tap on the glass. Like I said, no entering restricted areas. Now, does anyone have any ideas about why we're not allowed to tap on the glass? Because it'll break, killing all of us. So we get out of here. No one likes you. Now, the glass on these small tanks is half a thick inch. Glass on our largest tanks, which you'll see later, is over 20 inches thick. Perfectly safe. Anyone like to take another stab at why we shouldn't tap on the glass? I don't know. I know why. It gives the fish anxiety. Sure. Delaney is very smart. She was won the first place in the school science fair every year since 5th grade. That's right, and fish get sick when they're stressed, and they can even die from stress. All animals can die from stress, even humans. No, really? Well, yes, technically you're correct. But no worries about that here. We just want to make sure the little fishes are as comfortable and happy as possible. Darkness is making you feel uneasy. Jump when someone grabs your shoulders. Hey, head! Turn around. What I miss? Oh, she's here! She's not dead! Risha is whispering, shouting. It's visibly exciting, grinning ear to ear. Step away from the group to continue the conversation as the aquarium guide launches into a story about the aquarium's history. You scared me and you're super late. I was worried you wouldn't come. Of course I'm going. I would never miss out on this. You're a nerd. What took you so long? Oh, nothing. Just some stuff. So here? Yeah, why? I just think he's kind of cute. You know what? Go for it. Anyway, look at all these cool jellies. They're like little aliens. Aw, they're touching hands. Or, yeah. You watch jellies for a while. Some of them are kind of cute. Little ones that bob up and down, but some of them are bigger than what you expect. Whoa. Yeah, they are cute. They are pretty cute. Oh! Whoops. Jellyfish tentacles are extremely dangerous. Oh, they're gonna say poisonous. They can sting prey so that they're paralyzed. Can't do anything while the jellyfish digest them. Alright, that's true, Diane, but none of that can happen here. If I was him, I'd just punch her in the face. Can you imagine what it would be like? Paralyzed, frozen, unable to move while a predator uses its long tentacles to slowly, painfully raise you into their... Okay, thanks so much for the facts, Elaine. The ocean sure is a fascinating subject. Let's just deep ocean room and sit down our things, okay? Follow the group through the rest of the jellyfish exhibit. We need to be free of Delaine's terrifying facts until you stop the other kids filing into a room called the deep ocean room. In the doorway, you could see the large tank glass lines, entire wall, floor to ceiling. Something about that room. Something about the incredible vastness of the tank. That does really look like a portal to the ocean. And you get the impression of something huge moving towards you. A shark? Try not to worry, letting the others pass you. Hey, Misha, can you put my stuff near yours? Why, are you scared? Though I feel weird about that room. It just feels weird. Just take my bag. Fine, whatever, wait here. What kind of friend are you? Think about the ocean. You got water, deep water, so deep you can't see the bottom. Think about looking down, seeing nothing but darkness, because the sun can't penetrate anywhere near the seafloor. Oh, she's sweating. Why are you thinking about this? It gives you anxiety. You think about a giant mouth breaking through the darkness and has eyes and teeth and it sees you. Sharks are not like that. I'm sorry, sharks are not like that. Hey. She grabs your hand. Come on, we're going to the kelp forest. Oh, yeah. Toby and a few other boys run by laughing. You hesitate. She rolls her eyes. Look, don't worry, it's the kelp forest. Not scary at all. No sharks. Just some plants. Come on. She lowers her voice. It's our chance to hang out with the cool kids. I really want to look good in front of them. I know you're not, like, super into this, but it would mean a lot to me. Just try, please. What kind of friend are you? Thanks, Ed. You're a good friend. Come on. Cool kids. Thought, well, you're really in. Okay. You reach the kelp forest. Toby has already jumped the railing and has face pressed against glass. Okay. Toby, don't do that. You're going to get in trouble. I hope you'll get caught and kicked out. Whatever it is, I want to hang out with you dorks anyway. I'm only here because my dad made me come. Super stoked you made it, cuz. Stop being babies. I'm not gonna tap the glass so hard I murdered all the fish or anything. I'm just gonna die because I tapped the glass? Yeah, I'm not stupid. Not falling for that. Wow, Toby's so smart and he doesn't fall for facts. There's no tricking that guy. Total dingus. Anyway, isn't the glass like 2 feet thick or water? I think I tapped the glass once and it's gonna break. Sure, I need a super katana or something. It looks like you can freeze. Hey, I wonder what happens when you tap the glass with your freaky cyborg arm. Come on, try it. So we cut it off. Out. Stop being lame. Let's see what happens. Come on, head. We're not supposed to tap on the glass with our normal fingers. Wow. Douche. Not her weird robot arm. Maybe it's different. Maybe all the fish will come look at it. It'll be cool. Head, come on. Hey, you don't have to do it if you don't want to. I'm not doing it. Tell them it was my idea, please. No. Lame. Toby dabs, then runs out of the room. Hey, wait up. Come on, head. Oh, come on, head. Thought they were trying to make her do it. Toby is such a loser. Your commotion coming from the next room. You step out of the dark kelp forest exhibit, and the reflections of the water still touching your feet. It's a brightly little lit tide pool room. Oh, I like these little things. The touch tank in the corner sparkles in the sunlight. Here your classmates examine the dripping sand dollar, while others walk away in the tank gloomily after petting a hermit crab. Boy that you've never spoken to before approaches you. Sand dollars can feel pain, you know. That's cool. I don't know how to say it. That's uncool. Well, other fish can't feel pain. Huh. Hey. Do you want to poke the sea slug? No. Oh, the hermit crab then? Nope. But touch tank is part of the aquarium experience. At least touch the coral. Coral. Safe. Not moving coral. But it's alive. You can do that. Walk to touch the tank. Look down. Colorful shells and little coral lay on the sand. Dark purple sea slug climbs slowly over a rock. Take a deep breath. You're scared of it. Okay. Slowly you lower your hand into the tank. Why are you doing this anyway? Because Misha told you to. Why do everything Misha tells you to do? Is she even still there? Can't hear her. She can't really hear anything. Can't touch the water, it's cold. Throw into the tank, into the sand. What are you reaching for again? Coral? All you see is sand, ebbing gently into the water. Tech float upwards, touch your hand lower. You know, you could swear. I swear the tank didn't look this deep. Sand is ebbing less gently now. The guide is swirling. Can't see your hand. Water something murky, it's up to your elbow now. Sand turns like something underneath is rising. You have to pull your hand out of the tank, but something grabs you and pulls you back in. Hair rises your chest, you can barely breathe. Yeah, but no one seems to hear you. Raise your body against the tank and pull upwards. Fights you. It's pulling in deeper, deeper. Misha, help! On your entire weight against the tank. Feel a release. Suddenly you're standing next to the tank, surrounded by your lively classmates. Some of them are staring at you, giggling and pointing. In the tank, the water's clear, only a few inches deep. Sea flow continues a slow journey against the rock. Gee, stop yelling. What did you... Oh, a sand dollar. Cool. We should probably put it back. Wait, your hand. You're holding a sand dollar. I need, like, the touch tank. What do you mean? Look how you got into it. Your entire arm is wet. Check, your sleeve is dripping all the way up to your shoulder. See, you just have to try things. I know you get into it. Try not to make a scene next time, though. Anyway, Monica says there's a room with stingrays. Oh, yes! So we should go there next. Come on. Dude, stop freaking out. Everyone's going to think we're weird. How about you be an actual friend? It's probably just a hermit crab or something. You're fine. Let's just go next room, okay? Next room, I mean, it's normal, it's weird. Look, coral can look. That is coral, right? Time to get a headache. Hey, what's up? The longer you look at the touch tank, the more it hurts. Come on. Look away and allow me to pull you into the next room. Hey, what's up? Woo! Monica and Delaney already in the raised room when you enter. Besides, I'm harmlessly harmless. I don't know, these stingrays are freaking me out. Actually, those are manta rays. Those stingrays don't unless antagonized by a predator. Their barbed tails are only used for protection. Although they are closely related to sharks, they don't have bones, just like their shark relatives. I love stingrays. Rays glide through the water. I love them so much. The tank is really big. The biggest you've seen so far is making you uncomfortable. Step back and survey the room. Blake's detailing the different types of rays and facts about their natural habitat on the wall. I really want stingray. There's a doorway on the left side of the room with a restricted area. No entry sign in front of it. The room past the doorway is dark, but you can see something on the floor. Looks like a broom handle. Object is partially obscured by the doorway. Walk closer. Janitor's trash can and equipment are knocked over. Cleaning items strewn haphazardly on the floor, and there's something behind it. Get closer. What is that? Hey, head, how's it going? Yeah. Remember those restricted areas I mentioned before? This is one of those. So you're going to want to head back to the exhibits. We're kind of short-staffed these days. Janitor probably knocked it all over. We'll get it cleaned up quickly. That's why these areas are restricted, so kids don't see the messes we leave behind. Okay. Make your way back to the group. Let me count for 306 deaths by drowning per year. Wow, Delaney, you sure do know a lot of really bummer facts. I want to be a marine biologist someday, so I do know a lot of facts. Sorry if knowledge bombs you out. Chill, you guys are giving the fish anxiety. Whatever. Hey guys, come quick, they're feeding the sharks in the deep ocean tank. Well, we gotta take a selfie with that. That does sound pretty cool. Yeah, come on! Toby turns to follow Monica and Delaney, and he looks back. Misha, you coming? Sure, yeah. Doesn't hear you, or maybe she pretends not to hear you. She runs after the others. Wow! What a friend. The room is silent. You are alone, right? With the braids and then the handle of the room. Still breaking out of the restricted area. The guide wasn't here? Where did he go? Hear the heart beating faster. A sign on the wall points towards the hallway labeled Open Seas. Sounds fine. No. Walk towards it quickly. Immediately notice the change when you enter the open seas room. The room is circular, and unlike the other rooms, there are no tanks in the walls. You look up. Shiny fish in the circle around the top of the room. Giant circular tank. Tip him, breathing hard. Feel lightheaded. Signs it down on the floor. So this sucks. Didn't even want to come here. Why did you come here? Because Misha told you to come? Why? She doesn't seem to care now. She left. Maybe you're just her backup friend. Maybe she likes having you around in case there's no one better to hang out with. Maybe she likes that you don't have much other friends. Maybe she likes that you need her. You hold your bare arm against your chest, you're freezing, but also somehow sweaty. Monica only invited you because you're in her class and just to fight everyone. You want to talk to Monica like 4 times. Does she even know your name? Could be home doing something you enjoy, but instead you're here doing this because maybe people really wanted to believe Misha. Maybe you also wanted to feel wanted. Tilt your head back, stare up at the fish again. Try to focus on one fish, follow it all the way around the room. Keep losing in the swarm of the other, a niggle fish, which shimmers silver in the light. It's beginning to hurt looking up. My head hurts as well. There's quite a lot of water above you. How thick was the glass again? Headache. Hello. It's getting stronger, but you can't stop looking. You can't stop staring at the fish. Again, they feel a little motion sick. Sitting, but it hasn't helped you catch your breath. Oh god. Ain't that out of shape? What happens if you throw up in the aquarium? Do it. Maybe you go to jail. No. Fish jail, yeah. Take a deep breath and stare at a single point of glass in the tank. You focus on the area, usually. Now everything else in the glass cracks. What? Whoa, whoa. Fish swarm. Why do they have multiple eyes? 100,000 fish weaving in and out of the pack, in and out, holes inside of each other. Has no glassy eyes staring right at you. Oh god. There's so many of them, they create their own object, a heavy object, one that can crush you. Thousands of tiny writhing bodies. Pain because you upset them. Now they're dying and they're going to take you with them. Oh god. Swarm reaches out with a giant tendril, an arm bigger than your entire body, and plants it on the Z floor. What is happening? And from its writhing body, it extends another tendril and another, all bending at odd angles. Even though it's millions of fish, you feel a reverberation. Your bones and knees break to bend backwards. It tries to move. It can't. It's dying. It screams in pain, each limb breaking under the weight of the swarm. Each time a new one growing back. They all have eyes. They're staring at you. My god. The swarm screeches and bends and reforms into an enormous ball, and then a hole opens in the middle. Small at first, but now bigger. It's deep and black. You can't see the bottom, but just swarming, screaming, dying fish all the way into the void. It moves to swallow you. It does swallow you. And when you can't scream, you can't move, you can't breathe. Then you can, and you do, and you scream a lot, very loudly. You sit up from the floor. You don't even lie down. You stand up shakily and you run. You run, you don't look back. You don't look at where you're going. At some point, you hit a restricted area. You sign stumble, you keep running. It's dark, you slow down, you breathe. It's actually really dark now. Where are you? Half finished posters line the walls. Empty tanks sit on the floor. A table is knocked over. Up ahead, you see light peeking through a doorway. You enter. You. Head. Whoa. You're finally here. Whoa. Hi. Enjoying your trip to the aquarium? Is it playing out the way you expected? What did you expect anyway? You expect to have a nice time with your friends, making memories, learning about the natural world, growing as human beings. You anticipated some of it. Toby's crudeness, Monica's arrogance, Misha's neglect. But maybe you were hoping that in the end, despite everything, it would all be okay. You're broken. Desperate idiot. Vast oceans of infinite complexities. Doesn't even acknowledge your existence. 100 million miles of sea, a void, and you, alone. Stingrays. Come closer. This is part where it gets better, right? This is part where your friends run in and save you. Say they've been looking for you this whole time. They say they're sorry for leaving you alone. You feel comforted. You feel safe. You feel accepted. That's what happens next, right? They'll be here any second. I think I hear them now. My mistake. Must have been a stray Roomba. Your classmates are enjoying their night. They're enjoying each other's company. They're making memories. They're learning about natural. They're growing as human beings. They do not miss you. They don't even notice you're gone. Let's get closer. You came here to prove yourself. little stingrays. What did you prove? Prove that you were right about your classmates. Voice in your head, one that you could never quite silence. One that says you're better off without you. Did you really want to believe they were your friends? Or a tiny, bitter, angry part of you where it has been hurt and want to find justification for your anger, or your fear, or your pain? When you needed help, none came. Here you are, alone. So congratulations, little stingrays. You're right. What now, Head? I don't know. I go home? I'm not broken. What's that, little stingray? I'm not broken. Sure, lie to yourself. I'm not broken. I'm trying to help you. I'm trying to help you see the truth. I'm not broken. Give up. I'm not broken. Stop fighting. I'm not broken. Okay. Stare at your own reflection. Look at yourself in the eye. Say that again. I dare you. I am not broken. Fine. You need more proof then. Go ahead, find some. I think we already got our proof. I think we're good. Oh no, there's a... I know it's a shark. I don't know what kind. A glass tunnel. Large dark fish swim above you, around you. Enormous shadow blocks the light from above, then disappears. Was that a shark? We really don't like sharks. Keep walking. The light filter through the water, through the kelp, through the moving fish. It's odd. Oh, there we go. They're placed space evenly along the railing with fun facts, small blurbs about the creatures kept here. Days numb and directionless, you read them. Tuna can swim up at speeds of up to 70 43 miles per hour. I don't know what that. There are 30,000 different kinds of fish, all of which have their own colors and sizes. Many fish travel in schools to protect themselves from predators. Numerous sea dwellers use camouflage to blend in with their own environment and confuse their hunters. That's relatable. Back at the kelp forest, you remember this place. The room is cooler than you remember. It's been that hour since you were last here. And up ahead is that. Guys, it's me, I'm back. Toby, Monica, Delane, and Misha stand next to the kelp forest tank. Oh my god. So close, in fact, that they're completely backlit by the light from the tank. I have no idea what relief it is to find you guys. I don't think that's them. Guys. Oh my god. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Deep sea room, your worst fear, your only option. The large doors close behind you, then lock them. You don't get the sense that anything's following you. They want to be alone right now. Survey the room. Sleeping bags, backpacks litter the floor. Also small table stacked several feet high with LaCroix pants. Classic Monica. Only Monica. In close air spot, two familiar backpacks, yours and Misha's. Recent bag isn't rolled up like the others. Some Misha's laid out books, your her own sleeping bags next to each other, right up against the glass. You found the blanket in your backpack, your sleeping blanket from home. You folded it neatly over your sleeping bag. That was nice of her. Days and tired, you sit down on your sleeping bag and stare it up at the enormous tank. Huge sharks swim higher than you see. Smaller ones lurk near the bottom of the tank. It's almost like you're the one in the tank looking out of the window into the ocean. It's beginning to scare you again. You feel your pulse rising. You feel that headache coming on. Hi. You force yourself to look. On your peripherals, you see a giant shadow bigger than the others approach you from the right. You stare ahead. You will not look away. Then he's blink. Aww, he's so happy. happy. Harvey swims a giant lemon shark with a prosthetic fin. Oh. Skin shimmers under the filtered rays of light, just as it's about to swim as it turns. As few pass in front of you, lingering. Get the impression that it sees you. Hey there, friend. It flips its tail a little. It's not as scary as you thought it would be. I mean, sure, it's huge, but it's just swimming. It's kind of peaceful, actually. Lean back for a while and watch. Aww. Shark swims around, leaving in and out of the rocks, passing the other sharks, reaching the edge of the tank, but never quite straying far from where you sit. There's a plague at the bottom of the tank titled The Ocean Guardian. Picture of the shark or with the prosthetic fin. Meet Bruce, the lemon shark from the Atlantic Ocean. You may notice that Bruce is a little different from the other sharks. Bruce was heavily injured after a run-in with an illegal shark finning vessel. Due to the loss of his tail fin or caudal fin, Bruce has been fitted with a prosthetic, which allows him to swim as gracefully as the other sharks. Despite his trauma and injury, Bruce has a calm temperament. Be shy sometimes, but sharks are naturally social creatures. Bruce is no exception. He's especially friendly with sharks who are new to the aquarium, and is instrumental in accumulating sharks to the aquarium environment. So this, our handlers have nicknamed Bruce the Ocean Guardian. Fortunately, due to his injuries, Bruce is unable to survive in the wild. We're happy to provide a home for Bruce, our unique friend. Watch the sharks, lights of the tank, dance over you. And you know, you're beginning to get it. Why everyone loves aquariums so much. Sitting here watching those sharks is actually quite serene. You could sit here for hours. After a while, you hear the door open. Head! She runs over and hugs you. She hugs you so hard you almost fell over. So glad we found you. I was so scared. Is she crying? As you found a head, she's in here. Michael looks at you and smiles sort of tiredly. Her hair's a little frizzy. She's been running around. I've been looking all over for you, Head. Are you okay? That's good. We're all pretty freaked out. Oh my gosh, Head, finally, bro, it's you, man. My heart is pounding. I was worried you fell in a tank or something. Toby, isn't there something you wanted to say to Head? Something you've been talking about. Saying for the past hour, remember? Something like, I swear if we ever see her again, I'll tell her. What's the rest, Toby? Yeah, Head, I'm really sorry for bothering you earlier. I thought I was just being funny, but then you went missing, and I realized that maybe it wasn't very funny. I would have felt really bad if you got hurt or something. Anyway, I'm sorry. And I think your arm is really cool. It reminds me of Iron Man. Pew pew! Oh, yeah, that's it. Misha is still crying quietly into your shoulder. You've never seen her cry before. She's whispering something. I'm sorry. I'm glad you guys found me. I'm scared too. Yeah, this place is kind of freaky, and I wouldn't want to get lost here either. But they got some weird stuff hidden somewhere. Misha pulls away from me, wiping her face with her hand. So my eyes are red because I'm tired, not because I was crying, by the way. I wasn't. Yeah, Misha, sure. Head, are you sure you're okay? There's a first aid place. Or like, I don't know. Friends stare at you, they all look concerned. I look back at them for the first time tonight. You actually are okay. I'm okay. Prove it. Yeah, you're fine, you're a dork. Hey, you're my best friend. You're my best friend, too. Hey, you are my best friends, too. Ugh, Toby. It's a party over. All the classmates filter back to the deep ocean room. Don't hold flashlights or wear safety equipment. We're all excited to see you. They must have been looking really hard for you. Michael walks up to you and hands you a LaCroix. I will never know. Companions can take you home if you want. We didn't do the cake with presents because we were looking for you. Maybe we can cut you a slice of cake to go. You can have all the, the entire pile. Now we're not like best friends or anything, but like, can I hug you? Yeah. I'll hug you tight for just for a second, then let's go. Cool, well anyway, want me to tell my parents to take you home? Look around at your friends. Smiling, laughing, talking as they set up their sandbags. To look at things Bruce doesn't know the past. Feel comforted, feel safe, you feel accepted. Monica looks surprised. Okay, great, then let's do cake, I guess. Spend the rest of the night hanging out with friends. You eat cake and open presents, you play games, and eventually fall asleep under the watchful eyes of the ocean guardian. Aww. Smile. Smile. Is that him right there? No, there he is. Oh, whoa. Oh, this is giving me shivers. Guys. The shivers. Shiver me timbers. I got goosebumps. That was so good. No. I did? Oh my god. I wonder what I unlocked. Fishy. So that's it for Fishy, but I want to see what I unlocked. Hello? That was so cute. Like, at first I'm like, Toby, get out of here. Gosh. Gallery. Oh. Okay. Oh, the concept art. How do I get this one? Monster friends. What is this? This makes me want to go to an aquarium. I really hate aquariums so much. This is so cute. I need to know what this is. Maybe I have to get another ending for this. Anyways, that's Fishy. A really cute game. Did we stop? Sorry. Hope you like it. Yeah, just, you know, if you have a robot arm, you're not, you know, so different. You know? I'm gonna stop now. Bye.